Cathy Freeman's gripping life story is best told in Cathy's autobiography, Born to Run, which was published in 2007. Cathy's story of an unlikely triumph coming from a troubled youth into an Australian sporting icon is nothing shy of inspirational. Her great success and continued idolisation by the Australian public made her a hard option to overlook for the purpose of this study. Coming from quiet and humbled beginnings, Freeman's ability to have established herself as a national champion is a truly remarkable tale. For this reason, her name immediately sprung to mind when deciding the subject for my study. This stands as a testament to the name that Cathy has made for herself and what she's achieved in the sporting field. Cathy's successes can be partly attributed to the well-established and effective sport delivery systems within Australia. Sport delivery systems are the framework and the stepping stones put in place to guide athletes, coaches, administrators, and referees alike into higher levels of performance, leading from grassroots sports into the elite sporting scene. The sporting field is constantly developing and growing, and this is exactly why it's detrimental to analyse and develop the sports delivery systems. This enables our athletes the best opportunity possible to reach their maximum sporting potential and to adapt these systems in accordance with the ever-changing sporting environment. Cathy has always said that since she was born, it's been a dream of hers to win an Olympic gold medal. Cathy became involved in athletics at a very young age, and from her very first race at 8 years old, Cathy claimed that she was hooked on running. Cathy's first major showcase was her participating in the third leg of the 4x100m relay at the Auckland Commonwealth Games. After her team took home the gold medal, she became the first female Aboriginal to win a gold medal at an international athletics event.
After moving schools from Fairholme to Coralbin, Freeman's training intensified, and her trainer at the time, Mike Danilla, took a special interest in Cathy and pushed her harder on the track. After recognising Cathy's potential, Mike entered her into the Commonwealth Games in which she had such great success. This was essentially a life-changing experience for Freeman, kick-starting her professional career. This exemplifies how outstanding and efficient the sports delivery systems acted in enabling Cathy to compete on that day and granted her the opportunity to perform at that level. Cathy's achievements continued to grow after she moved to Melbourne following her Commonwealth Games success. Freeman was selected to run in the 1990 World Junior Championships. Despite placing fifth in the final, in her autobiography Born to Run, Freeman writes about how beneficial all the exposure and training is to her development, once again attributing these to solid sports delivery systems at play. Proving her development, and once again the effectiveness of the sports delivery systems in place within Australia, Cathy's next World Junior Championship she came away with a silver medal. 1992 was the year Cathy really put her front leg forward and got her career jump-started, after she competed in her first Olympic Games and reached the second round of the 400m event. Freeman's development and progression into the elite level is somewhat difficult to analyse thoroughly as athletics and the Olympics as a whole have very different sports delivery systems compared to generic sports such as soccer or basketball. Mainstream sports, like these, often have many pathways and academies a player goes through to reach the top division teams. However, in Cathy's case, she was running for school teams all through her junior years until she trialled for the Commonwealth Games as stated before. From here, her career skyrocketed into the professional scene bypassing all the development, academies and programs usually associated with mainstream sport. The format of Olympic running events, including Freeman's specialty, the 400m, all feature heats and rounds that lead to the final. Generally, the format has athletes partake in three rounds, the first round, semi-finals, and final. This, of course, however, is dependent on the number of athletes in an event and may require a preliminary round. This format leaves no room for an off day, as for the most part, failing to perform in one round will leave you eliminated from the competition. With regard to sports delivery systems, this can, of course, be beneficial or a hindrance, depending on the athlete and many other various factors. Over the course of Freeman's career, she obviously had a great sporting success with various gold and silver medals in both the Commonwealth Games and also at the Olympics. Although, Cathy also won honours as Young Australian of the Year, Aboriginal Athlete of the Year, and Australian of the Year. Being an autobiography enabled the author, Cathy Freeman, to explain a very in-depth analysis of her sporting journey. She mentions many key dates, events, and individuals who were key factors in her success as an athlete. She gives credit and acknowledges many individuals and groups who play a huge role in getting her to be the great Australian athlete she is. Despite not directly referencing sport delivery systems, Cathy does make note of the teams and competitions that acted as these sport delivery systems in moving her into the elite scene. Overall, I think it's quite clear how Cathy Freeman utilised the sport delivery systems available within Australia to boost her professional career into the elite level. Despite running being very unusual in terms of the sports delivery systems and pathways compared to mainstream sport, I believe Cathy, alongside her experienced coaches, exemplified how effective these sport delivery systems are at enabling athletes to maximise their potential.